What is the difference with dynamic IP versus static IP? Well, if you don't know, I'm going to clear that up for you in this short video. When you first start learning about computer networking and IP addresses for all of the components, the computers, devices, printers, servers, etc., on a network, you quickly start hearing the terms dynamic IP and static IP used repeatedly. So what are technicians and admins talking about when they use these terms? To further explain the difference, I highly recommend you watch this video called What is DHCP on my YouTube channel, as it will give you a good foundation for understanding dynamic IPs. But here's the short and simple of these two terms. If you manually go into the operating system on each client and tell it what IP address and subnet mask it's going to have on its network card settings, and you manually tell it what the default gateway IP address is on the network, you are doing what's called static IP assignment. In other words, you tell that device or computer what its IP address, subnet mask, and default gateway IP address are, and it only uses those settings. And this can be easy to maintain on a small to even a medium-sized computer network. But when you have a large to extremely expansive computer network in a company or organization with, say, several thousand employees or users on that network, you can't just physically log in to each device on that network and assign it an IP address. If you do, you can run into multiple issues. For one, you will spend all day, every day, just assigning IP addresses, especially if you have new users or devices continually needing to connect to your network. Statically assigning IP addresses becomes futility. One of the other big issues you'll probably encounter by statically assigning IP addresses on a bigger network is that you have to keep track of the IP addresses you've already used and make sure you don't assign the same IP address to two or more different devices. And what if a device you assigned an IP address to stops being used or connecting to the network? How do you know that an IP address is available to be used for some other device? This is where DHCP comes in handy, as it hands out and keeps track of the necessary IP addresses on a larger network. And by using a DHCP server, again, check out the video on what is DHCP. By using a DHCP server, you are using what is referred to as dynamic IP addressing. So to sum it up really simply, static IP means you are manually assigning IP addresses, subnet masks, and the default gateway IP address to every component or client on a network. Dynamic IP means you are probably using a DHCP server on your network to actually handle advertising out available IP addresses, subnet masks, and default gateway. And the DHCP server is keeping track of what components or devices on the network are currently using those IP addresses and which aren't, so it knows what IP addresses are available to be used by new devices that need IP addresses when they first connect to the network.